We place such an emphasis on, well, I can't talk to this person because they don't speak my language. Well, actually, nonverbal communication, some people would say, is as high as 80-90% of all our communication with each other. And so what is it that we can do from a nonverbal communication perspective to elicit information from the patient or the family member, especially when there has been a poor prognosis or diagnosis? And so firstly, from a nonverbal communication perspective, you know, there's the touch, there's the smile, there's the posture, you know, and when you are talking, there's the tone. All of this comes into play, and it leads into building a trust and a relationship so that the person, whether they speak English or not, will be more open, and then will be, you know, more hopefully there can be a bit of a dialogue going rather than a one-way street.